Yeah, the Warburg Museum up here, up by the little municipal airport, they've got a perimeter road that runs around the outside edge. Again, you know, slow speeds, but lots of twists and turns. Kind of makes for a fun ride. They're coming up on it now. Listen to that downshift. Listen to that thing, the engine braking. Get a little gravel there. One of the things I find about the bike that I won't say is annoying, but it's different than what I'm used to. When you put the directional on, the little arrow comes on that tells you the directional's on, but it doesn't flash. So sometimes you forget to turn it off. Again, that's something I'll just have to get used to. Nothing really wrong with the bike, it's just the way it's designed. But it's just different than what I'm used to. The little flashy thing kind of draws your attention to it. Reminds you, hey, turn that thing off, jerk. There's a Warburg Museum. Yeah, I'm going to give this high marks on the fun factor. Just the overall feel of this bike on roads like this is just a lot of fun. Again, it's, you know, when you ride a road like this, you want to be on a bike that you feel confident on, that you feels like it's going to hold the road good and brake and do all the things you expect it to do. And I would say this bike does all that pretty well. Again, you know, one of the negatives of the bike, you know, that you get bad marks on, you do have to apply a little bit more brake pressure to get a good solid stop, but you know, it does work. You know, once you do that, I mean, it does stop confidently. Love the sound of this bike. You're hearing that. That is a sweet sound. There's some bumps in the road. Pop back in the exhaust, I say I'm gonna have to run a jet kit in this thing here pretty soon. It does have a Scorpion exhaust on it, which makes a sweet sound. that's the wind of the twisties. So this is Chip again from the Arconic Sports Cycle Motorblog. Talk to you real soon. Bye.